Okay, boys, you know the rules. Remember, obey my commands at all time. Defend yourselves at all time. God bless. Touch gloves. Let's do it.
The magnetism of Amir Khan. The mass appeal of the 31-year-old who is just always big news for British sport. Out of the ring problems, out of the jungle, and back from what was a serious knockout defeat, all being up at middleweight, to Canelo Alvarez. But at his best, what a brilliant talent he is. The hand speed, the skill set. And what can Phil LaGreco do to dampen this homecoming party? Good uppercut from Khan straight away. It looks right at the shot, and he's down in the only 15 seconds. Phil LaGreco with a right hand. And Amir Khan having the perfect comeback here. Reminiscent a little bit of when he took out Dimitri Salita early. Can he do it to Phil LaGreco? He's all over the place.
Blistering hand speed on.
And it's all over in 40 seconds. Amir Khan returns to world boxing. And Phil LaGreco is absolutely blown away. And listen to this reception. Do they feel shortchanged? Not one little bit.
Not one bit. Absolute blistering hand speed. We said before the fight, we need to see what Khan has left. If he has anything left at all, then he's going to be devastating. He is devastating. The hand speed is something else. And the hand speed, it looked exactly the same as the 17-year-old kids that we've seen based on the scene.
Wow. Into perspective, no one thought Phil LaGreco was going to win this, but it was the manner of how he went about it. Anthony Crawler said on the JD Ringside show last night, it will go points. Most people thought it would go long. In 40 seconds, Amir Khan has announced himself back on the stage, the welterweight stage, the super welterweight stage. Kell Brook at ringside, there he is. Look, he looks a bit stunned himself. And the boos ring out. Oh, I don't think he's worried one little bit. I tell you what, Paul, Khan Brook is a must at some point soon.
Listen, it's been a great fight over the years. Amir thought he had bigger fish to fry. Kell Brook was winning the titles down at welterweight. He took a gamble with the Golovkin fight. It didn't pay off. He came back. He had the special.